I think from the corporate point of view, maybe they would be disappointed, I guess, because in a year like this, there was an outside chance maybe of a cut in corporate tax rates, actually. That hasn't happened. Probably one reason could be that in a election year, in a year in which you're going for elections, you wouldn't want to be seen as a pro-corporate government by cutting tax rates, actually. So it's been a disappointment probably for them. By extending it from 50 crore to 250 crores, that will mainly cover micro and medium companies, but not the big corporates. But at the end of 4 years, actually, after the promise they gave, I think probably they have enough reasons to crimp off tax rates, corporate tax rates not going down. And particularly when you want to promote private investment. But to me, the more important point is not just the cutting of tax rates. I really wonder, when tax rates have not been cut, both personal and corporate, whether there is uncertainty even on expectations of revenue next year. It certainly is an election year budget. If you look at some of the targeted spending, as we discussed earlier, in some of the sectors, the farm sector, the rural, for the rural sector, and in some of the other areas, actually, healthcare spending, infrastructure spending, and some of those things are clearly and what you have power and for free gas, extending that scheme, that's worked. I think I'm certain it worked. They would have calculated it, and the healthcare thing, I think, is really positive. How it will play out, I'm not very sure. This also goes with a certain theme, actually, from what I could make out. One of the messages which was being passed at a meeting which he had with global businessmen was that the bottom of the pyramid theory works. That once you empower many of those people below poverty, plus people who are at that level, progressively, he thinks that when they grow, when economically, when there are more benefits they gain, there is a market which will open up over the period of time. That's the message which he gave, actually, to people, to a large gathering of global businessmen over there. And to me, some of the things which he said, actually, is with a in a pattern with what he has and his vision, in fact, actually. That's where it is. That's probably something completely different from what the previous government believed in, the UPA, where I think they thought the growth was a driver, and once you achieve high growth, alongside, actually, you could reduce the number of people below the poverty line. That's something which many economists also supported. Maybe that's not what Mr. Modi believes in, but I think they would like to believe that this is going to help them in some of the states which are coming up for elections. They probably need to be a little worried about the urban middle class and the fact that India is urbanizing fast. So I don't know the signals which are going to come out of this, in fact, for people in some of the big cities, actually. I don't know whether they are going to be particularly happy. That's something which they will need to address. But they seem to be pretty confident. It's a government with a leader, after what we have seen, after a very long time, who seems to be very, very confident about himself and about what he's doing. I'm not too sure how corporates look at it, actually, ultimately. Well, certainly, I think if this government comes back anyway with greater numbers, any corporate businessman would be happy with a government with higher numbers rather than a coalition government.